What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the video. Breathe. Let's go. This is actually the next day. We're actually post gun club. We went out to Lupe Tortilla last night and it was unbelievable. Unbelievable. The steak and chicken fajitas. Fajita. Very, very good. So if you're ever in Texas, I don't know if it's a whole Texas thing or a Houston thing, but Lupe, that's the place to go. We're in for legs. We're talking a little bit. It's very loud in here. We might get copyrighted, so we're going to try to keep these clips below like 30 seconds. So I'm going to shut up and I'll see you in the next clip. Let's warm up.
All the way. Come on, let's go again. Up, little tuck at the top. There we go.
Oh, you can see that I'm literally owning those eccentrics so much. The reason why I'm doing that is twofold. Number one, I'm doing the whole stack already for 10 reps. So in order for you to progress, like, you want to make that weight as heavy as possible so you've got more runway to progress. Not only that, if you are literally lifting less total like weight through the joint, you best believe that joint is getting protected. So if you can create that movement to make it harder for that muscle, or more accurate for that muscle, so the failure point of how much weight you can put through is less, but you're getting the same stimulus, that's a very good thing. Look to elongate those eccentrics. Come on. Ooh. Keep it moving. Come on.
One more.
Keep it heavier.
Wow. Easy, Josh. Good. Loads more there. All the way. And again. Up. Little touch. Nice and slow. Good.
So I often get a lot of questions kind of about the training order that we go through, because more often than not, I'm doing a hamstring curl, maybe an adductor and then a leg extension before I do any of my big compound squats or compound leg press, for example. And the main reason for that is because our ability to get into like a fully short, and I've said this many times on camera before, but I like to reiterate because that's who I am. To get into a fully contracted position, that gets harder and harder as you build up fatigue. And I find that doing those hack squats or leg presses first, and then the leg extension after, it just completely compromises that leg extension or leg curl afterwards. But if I can take them out and put them before, I find that the compromisation into the main compounds is much, much less than if it was the other way around, if that makes sense. I hope the hand movement made that easier.
Good. All the way. Little touch. Good.
Oh.
Let's go then. I'll get you going. Good, again.
Oosh.
Good.
Ow. That is sore. I got a big pump there.
Good. Let's go.
I got it.
All the way.
Watch out behind you.
Good. Let's go.
That's it. Oh shit. Oh, my legs. Absolutely blown, mate. I wish I got a connection to my anywhere else in my body like I do my legs. Fuck. Oosh.
Good, moving well. Keep it going, Josh. Up. Good. Good, again. Good, again. Up.
Yeah, one more.
Take another rest. Come on now. Up. Good, haven't even touched it. Good set.
Oh, that's good. Have you guys ever taken a real strong pre-workout and then between sets you're like, fuck, I can't get my breath back? Quite often that's just where the caffeine's so high, the stimulant's so high, that your heart rate just doesn't come back down because you've got so much stimulant going on. And actually, part of that process of, you know, recovering the body, moving blood around, heart rate has to come down. If you can't do that, it's going to be much harder to recover. I had a lot of caffeine this morning, that's what it is.
Good. Good. I'm here, Josh. Good. My guy.
For summer training, this is almost, this is the reason why we came here. So without further ado, guys, summer shredding 2022 October, they have two shows. This is supposed to be a madness inside. I've obviously got an understanding of how these things are run, so I'm very excited to see.
They even led me to the hospital because my esophagus got damaged. I was 270 pounds in April 2021. After going through that scary life-changing moment, the hardest I've ever been in my entire life, I realized that it was time to take action, to finally find and love myself. I didn't.
Watching the transformations, we all got teary. Well, I did anyway, and Mitch did next to me. Just seeing people come together, much more of like a community vibe, you know. Seeing people come together and appreciate people's hard work. People lost hundreds of pounds in the last year. It's just so, so surreal to watch that. I'm honestly massively motivated. So, transformation class is good. The standard is obviously like an amateur level, so it's an amateur level, but everyone had fun. The show was well run, really good, really well lit. And I think if anyone was to do like a first show, I think this is the place to do it. So get yourself out here. Time for burgers. Let's go. Josh, your order is ready, Josh.
There.
Which one's which?
My four.
Cheers,
Jim.
Good.
Rye bread is the wrong choice, but a burger is fucking good. Yeah.
Nice.
Okay. Jalapeno mash. Jalapeno potato salad. Also very good. Very good. This is Bubba's Texas Barbecue. Bubba's Texas Burger Shack. We're literally under an underpass. This is American food right now. American.
Yeah. Now we're talking.
It's a good burger.
Yeah, it's good.
I've been trying to do anything to curb my hunger at night. I'm still 8 weeks post-show and I'm still absolutely starving hungry every day. So I'm doing my best. So I'm nailing my sweet tooth with some protein yogurt and zero calorie sugar. So just protein and basically just stuff that's not very good for your stomach. This is my new technique. Just like put this into the tub and I'll keep eating until this is not in the tub anymore. And then we're good to go. That's it. Half lounge day, 3 or 4, or 3 and 4. Summer shredding, lovely burger, protein yogurt. What more do you want? We'll see you tomorrow for the next video. Peace, everybody.